Hello everyone, I am Divya, your math facilitator. So in this class, we are going to discuss exercise 4.2 problems, question number 6 to 10. Okay, so let's begin the session. So places A and B are 100 km apart on a highway. So you have a highway, for example, this is a highway. So on this highway, you have places A and B, right? So I have place A here. And for example, place B is here. Okay, one car and the distance between these two places is 100 km. Okay, between place A and B, the distance is 100 km. One car starts from point A. So there is a car which is starting from point A. Okay, and it is and another car is starting from point B. So there is one car which is starting from point A and there is one more car which is starting from point B, right? So if the car travels in the same direction, if both the cars are traveling in the same direction, for example, if the first car is traveling in this direction, second car is also traveling in the same direction towards the right. So they meet in 5 hours, okay? So both the cars are traveling, so at some point of time somewhere here, both the cars are meeting. Okay, so both of them are meeting somewhere here. Right, beta. At this point, say for example, this point is C. Right. So, and if they travel towards each other, for example, if they are traveling towards each other, if first car is traveling towards this direction and second car is traveling towards this direction, both the cars are traveling towards each other, so they meet in 1 hour. So, if they are traveling towards each other, they meet at some point in 1 hour. Okay? And if they are traveling in the same direction, like in the first case, this is the first case. Both are traveling in the same direction. First car is traveling in this direction. Second car also is traveling in this direction. Then both of them will meet at some point C in 5 hours. Okay? So, the time taken in the first case is 5 hours. So, in 5 hours, they are meeting. Clear with this? So, now, we need to represent the same statements mathematically and solve it. Okay, so you need to find the speed of the two cars, right? So you need to find speed of the two cars. So what I am doing is I will take let us take speed of first car. Okay, let us take this way. Let speed of first car is x kilometer per hour. And the speed of second car, I am taking it as y kilometer per hour. Okay, speed of first car is x kilometer per hour. Speed of y car is y kilometer per hour. This is x kilometer per hour car. And this is y kilometer per hour car. Okay, speed. Now, simple logic, beta. You just think and tell me. So, if both the cars are traveling in the same direction. And both the cars are traveling in the same direction. So, when will both the cars meet? Now, whose speed is more? Can you tell me whose speed is more? Obviously, see, this first car has to travel this distance and also cover this distance. Suppose they are meeting at point C. Car B is traveling this distance, BC. Car A should start from here, travel this entire distance. So, obviously, car A should be fast. Isn't it? Car A should be, the speed of car A should be more than B. Only then it will overtake this entire distance and then they will meet at some point. Isn't it? So, if a question is asked which car is of more speed, it is car A. Right? Yes. And let us proceed. Right. Yes. So, now, what about the distance traveled by the cars? So, distance traveled by first car is how much, beta? See, now both the cars are traveling, time traveled for both the cars is 5 hours. Both the cars are traveling 5 hours, isn't it? Now, what is the distance traveled by the first car? Both are traveling for 5 hours each. Okay, first car is also traveling 5 hours, second car is also traveling 5 hours. Now, the distance traveled by first car is nothing but speed is equals to distance by time. You all know this. Speed is equals to distance by time, isn't it? So, what is distance? Can I write distance is equals to? Can this distance is equal to speed into time? isn't it? So the distance traveled by first car is nothing but speed of first car is x kilometer into time traveled is 5. So candidate, distance traveled by first car is 5x kilometer, right? And what about the distance traveled by second car using the same logic? Distance traveled by second car using the same logic, it will be 5 into y, isn't it? Speed of second car is y, time taken is 5. Clear, beta? So this is a relation which we are using. Speed is equal to distance by time. Distance is speed into time. So speed of first car is x kilometer, time it is traveling is 5. Okay, 5 hours. Similarly, for the second car is also traveling 5 hours and it is traveling at the speed of y kilometers. So distance traveled is 5y. Clear? So this distance, let me represent here. So this entire distance, car A is starting from this point and traveling this entire distance. One second. Car A is starting at this point and traveling this entire distance. Okay? This entire distance till this point C. Okay, so this distance is 5x. Clear? Now let us consider the next distance. Car B is starting at this point, at point B, and it is traveling this distance, isn't it? So car B is traveling from point B to C. Now, can we say that? Now, here by looking here, I can see that car A is traveling this extra distance 100 kilometer. Car A is traveling this extra distance 100 kilometer. Or if I say this is how I can represent, I can say that distance traveled by first car is nothing but A to C. Let me write it this way, beta. I'm making it more easy. See here, from point A to point C it is traveling. So point A to point C, I can break it into two parts. A to B is one part and B to C. So can I write AC as AB plus BC? Isn't it? AC I can write as AB plus BC. But the entire AC, the distance is 5x. You have taken the distance traveled by the entire car is what? It is 5x. First car. So this is nothing but 5x. Right? So can I write AB is equals to 5x minus BC? Okay, that is equals to 5x minus BC is what? BC is nothing but the distance traveled by the second car. Right, see, the second car has traveled this distance. This distance you have written it as 5y. So, can you write it as 5y? But what is AB? See here, from A to B, in the question they gave you the distance is 100 kilometers. So, is this 100? Did you get this? So, this is your equation 1. Okay, and you can take 5 common from this. So, x minus y equal to 100. Let me write it here. So, I have 5 into x minus y is 100. So, x minus y is nothing but 100 divided by 5. So, x minus y, you will get it as 20. Okay? Clear till here? How did I get this relation? By using the distance traveled. Distance traveled, you know, from the figure you can see, first car has traveled the entire distance AC. But AC is in two parts. There is a point B in between. So AC I can write as AB plus BC. Okay. AB is 100 kilometer given in the question. BC is nothing but the distance traveled by the second car. That is what we substituted and we got this. Clear, beta? So this, let us take it as equation 1. Now how will you get the second equation using the second condition? Now what is the second condition given in the question? See, from here they gave you the second condition. If the car travels towards each other. Okay, now in this case, you have point A here, point B, point C. Okay, now point A, this car and this car, they are traveling towards each other. They are coming towards each other. So, for example, this point C will be here now. Okay, somewhere here in between. Let us take a different point otherwise. Okay, it will avoid confusion. So, these two cars are meeting at some point D here. Okay, in between. Car A is coming, car B is coming. So they will meet here in between, isn't it? So this entire distance, you know, it is 100. Okay. For example, if the distance traveled by car A is how much? Let me write it here. Now time taken by both the cars or time traveled by both the cars is 1 hour. It is given in the question. See here. They are meeting in 1 hour. So time they are traveling. So this car is traveling for 1 hour and this car is also traveling for 1 hour. Okay, and they are meeting at this point D. Now, can you tell me what is the distance traveled? Same like the previous one. Distance traveled by first car will be how much beta? Car will be speed into time. Speed is first car speed is same x kilometer and the time is 1. So x into 1 will give me x. And the distance traveled by the second car. Okay, here speed into time again. Speed of second car is y, time is 1. So here it is y. Now here you can see the distance traveled by the first car is x. You got it as x. Distance traveled by second car is y kilometer. So, and this entire distance AB is 100. So AB is given as 100 in the question. But AB is nothing but I can write it as AD plus DB, isn't it? AD plus DB. A to D distance is x plus D to B distance is y, that is equals to 100. This is 100. So this is your equation 2, right? So equation 1 is x minus y is 20. Equation 2 is x plus y is 100. Now simply add both of them, plus y minus y gets cancelled and you have 2x is equals to 120 or x is equals to 60. Now substitute x equal to 60 in equation 1. So equation 1 is x minus y is 20. So 60 minus y is 20 or y will be how much beta? Y will be 60 minus 20, it will be 40. So x is nothing but speed of first car, isn't it? Speed of first car, it is 60 kilometer per hour, x kilometer per hour. Speed of second car is nothing but y. It is 40 kilometer per hour. Don't forget to write the units. They are very important. Is this clear? Okay. So this question is little complicated. I hope I made it easy for you. Let's move on to the next question. But before that, if you understood this, then do like the video. Yeah. Okay, yes, the seventh question. Two angles are complementary. Now, what do you understand by complementary? Sum of the angles is 90 degrees. Complementary angles means sum of the two angles is 90 degrees. This is what we know. The larger angle is 3 less than twice the smaller angle. Do you remember we have done supplementary angle question? Question number 3, I guess. Okay, the same exercise. So, this is a similar question now. So, solution. Let one angle, I am taking it as x. Okay. The other angle, let's take it as y. Okay. Now, sum of two angles are complementary, which means sum of complementary angles is how much beta? Sum of complementary angles is nothing but 90 degrees. Okay. So, x plus y, these are the two angles. If I am adding, I am getting 90 degrees. This is my equation 1. Now see the second condition given in the question. From here the second condition starts. The larger angle is 3 less than twice the measure of the smaller angle. Suppose for example, let us assume x is the larger angle. Okay, let x is the larger angle. So given, what is given? The larger angle is, okay, x is 3, it is 3 less than. What is the meaning of less? Less means minus, subtraction. Okay. So, minus 3, 3 less than, 3 less than whom? 3 less than twice the measure of the smaller angle. Twice matlab 2, so 2 times the smaller angle. Okay, understand the question once again. The larger angle here in this case we have taken x. X is 3 less, less means minus. So, it is minus 3. From where should you minus 3? From where should you subtract 3? You should subtract 3 from twice. Twice means 2 times the smaller angle. Smaller angle is y. 2 times smaller angle is 2 into y. Okay. And 2 into y. From this you are subtracting 3. So the equation is x equals to 2y minus 3. Or you can write the same equation as x minus 2y is 3. This is your equation. Now let's solve 1 and 2. X plus y is 90. X minus 2y is 3. Okay. It is minus 3. Okay, now let us subtract and see. Plus x minus x cancel. So you have 3y is equals to 93 और y I'll get it as 93 divided by 3 or y is equals to 31. Now substitute y equal to 31. Substitute y equal to 31 in equation 1. So how much will you get? But equation 1 is x plus y is 90. So x plus y is 31 is equals to 90. So x is equals to 90 minus 31. So here you will get the answer as y is nothing but 59. Okay, sorry, the other angle is 59. So the two angles are x is 59, y is 31. Therefore, the complementary angles are, the complementary angles are 31 and 59. Clear beta? Degrees. Okay. So, and one more very important information. Do join the Telegram channel. Telegram channel link I'll give you in the description. So, by joining that Telegram channel, you'll get the notes. So, the notes of class 10 I have already prepared. So, it is free. Okay. So, I'll give you the notes of class 10. It will be in Telegram channel. Each and every exercise problem I have done it. Okay. So, you can take it, download it free from the Telegram channel. I'll give you the link. Right. So let us proceed. Yes, before moving on to the next question, let me tell you about the free class which I am taking on Unacademy. Right, so I am taking a free class on August 1st, 12 p.m. Okay, this Sunday I am going to take a free class on trigonometry. So do join the class. It's a completely free class and I'm going to discuss the concept of trigonometry, along with we are going to have very interesting and engaging poll questions. And the top students, top learners will receive e-certificates from me, right? And it's a completely free class. Since I can take poll questions there, the class will be more interesting and engaging. And I will discuss the concept or the concept of trigonometry, as well as I'll give you practice questions also, so that you can complete that particular concept in that hour. It's a completely free class, so you can join the class using the code GD10. Okay, I will give you the link of this class in the description box. Okay, I'll give you the link in the description box. So you can go, click on the description box, click on that link and you'll be directed to the page like this. You can see my profile picture, my name, right? And here you'll find a button, enroll, green color enroll button. You'll find, click on that. So then you'll find this message called, we will notify when it is live. Okay, so whenever I am live, you'll get the notification. It is on August 1st, 12 p.m. Even if you forget, you'll get a notification to join the class, right? So you can join. And also, you can share this class with all your friends by clicking on the share button. Okay, so do share it and ask them to use the code GD10 and do attend this free class. So let's make it a big number so that everyone gets the maximum benefit of this free class, right? And if more students join, the quiz will be more interesting, isn't it? And you will have leaderboard also, by which you can see whether you are, you know, standing on the top position or not. And the top learners will anyway get e-certificates, right? Yes. And if you want to join my plus class, I also take plus classes on Unacademy. So you can join my plus classes every day 4 o'clock and Monday to Friday 4 o'clock and Monday, Wednesday, Friday 7:15 I take classes on plus. So we will also have a regular doubt clearing session in plus classes. Right, so you can use this code GD10 to join the plus class and get a 10% discount. Yes, and also you'll have weekly plus test series in plus classes. And these are the new batches which have started based on your term 1 syllabus beta. So you can join these batches also by taking a subscription. The subscription prices are very minimum. So if you take a subscription, it is for 12 months. That means for 1 year, it is 15,000. Okay, so with this one single subscription, you can join unlimited classes. Every Monday, you have batches coming up, so you can join all the batches. You'll have number of test series which will be launched. You can join them. You'll have raise your hand feature wherein you can actually talk to us. You can clear your doubts. You can talk to us live in the class, right? So all these are the features of Plus. And also, you'll have structured courses. You can get your complete practice here. So you can use this code GD10 to get a 10% discount on your Plus subscription. So as I told you, for 12 months, it is 15,000, which means for 1 month, it is 1250 for all the subjects. And you'll learn from top educators with unlimited classes. If you apply this code GD10 around 1125, you can get your subscription, right? And you can join these classes. Okay, so the links of all these badges and the special class I will give you in the description. Do follow. And yes, let's proceed to the next question. a dictionary has total of 1382 pages. Okay, so I have a dictionary. In the dictionary, the total number of pages are how many, beta? 1382. So now this dictionary, we are breaking it into two parts. So the dictionary is broken into two parts, right? So this part, I'm just considering the number of pages in this part as X, and in the second part, I'm considering the number of pages as Y. Let us write. So let the number of pages in first part is X, and number of pages in second part, we are considering it as Y. So total number of pages X plus Y will be the total number, isn't it? So X plus Y is nothing but the total number of pages in the dictionary, 1382. This is your equation 1. Now see the second part. Now from here your second condition starts. They are saying that the second part of the book has 64 pages more than the first part. Okay, second part is nothing but Y. Okay, second part is nothing but Y. Or let me write it this way. Second part of the book has how many pages more? More means I told you it is addition, isn't it? More means I told you it is addition, plus. So plus second part has 64 pages more. So you are adding 64 to whom? Than the first part. Okay, first part. So second part has 64 pages more than the first part is nothing but second part is equal to first part plus 64. So second part is Y. You have taken it as Y. So Y is equals to X plus 64 is the condition. Let us write in order. So X minus Y will be 64. This is your equation 2. Right? Now let us solve both the equations. So I have X plus Y is equals to 1382. X minus Y is equals to 64. So plus Y minus Y cancels. I have 2X is equals to 2 plus 4 is 6. And here it is 14, 4, 1. So X is equals to 1446 divided by 2. You will get it as 2 7s are 14, 2 2s are 2 3s are. So X is 723. Okay, the first part number of pages are 723 plus. Now how many pages the second part has? See here. Second part. Now let us substitute. X equals to 723 in equation 1. Okay, so you will have equation 1 is X plus Y is equals to 1382. You can substitute in any equation. You can take equation 2 also. So X is 723. So 723 plus Y is equals to 1382. So Y is equals to 1382 minus 723. Actually, in this case, equation 2, if you take it, will be more easy calculations. Okay, I'll show you. So it is 7. So you have 9, 5 and 6. So 659. Okay, now how do you check? How do you check? So just add 659 here. So 659 plus 723 should give you 1382. Okay, so this is 12, 8 and 13. So your answer is correct. Now here as I told, you can take the second part. Second equation is simple. X minus Y is 64 and you can do. Okay, so you'll get a simpler calculation. If you take X minus Y is 64, so X is 723 you got, isn't it? So 723 minus Y is equal to 64. So Y will be 723 minus 64 will be Y. Okay, so again you will get the same answer. So whichever way you feel easy, you can take it, no problem. And so therefore the final conclusion will be the number of pages. Whatever is asked here in the last question, last part of the question, how many pages are there in each part? The number of pages in each part are how many, beta? In the first part, it is 723 and 659. Each part are 723 and 659. That's it. So next question, a chemist has two solutions. Okay. So there is a chemist who has two solutions here. Okay. This is one solution. And yes, this is the other solution. Okay, chemist has two solutions. Okay, one is 50% solution. So this solution is 50% solution, and this solution is 80% solution. Now, what do you mean by 50% solution, 80% solution? Which means 50% it is acid and 80% it is acid. Okay, that is the meaning of this. Let's read the question completely. a chemist has two solutions of hydrochloric acid. Okay, so both are HCl. This is also HCl. This is also HCl, hydrochloric acid. But this is 50% concentrated HCl. This is 80% concentrated HCl. So how much of each should be used? So you are used to obtain a 100 ml solution of 68%. Okay, now in this beaker, I am taking a solution. Okay, which is the quantity of this solution is 100 ml and it is 68%. Okay, this is 68% solution. Now you should mix some part of this and some part of the second solution, some part of the first solution and some part of the second solution to get the new solution, which is 100 ml. The quantity is 100 ml and the quantity is 100 ml and the concentration is 80%. So how concentration is 68%, isn't it? Yes. So how shall we do this now? So understand better, very simple. So I give you the steps. Now for example, I am mixing little amount of the first solution in the beaker, little amount of the first solution, little amount of the second solution, and the total solution in the beaker is how much? 100 ml, isn't it? So let us take x ml of first solution and y ml of second solution. Okay, I'm just taking x ml of first solution and y ml of second solution. That means from this beaker I'm taking x ml. Okay, I'll just show you here. From this beaker I'm taking x ml of solution and mixing here, and from this beaker y ml of solution and mixing here. So this total solution now in the beaker is 100 ml. Okay, so x plus y, total x quantity from one beaker plus y quantity from the other beaker I'm mixing, and total I'm getting 100 ml. For example, 40 ml from here, 60 ml from here. Okay, we don't know how much we are taking, so I'm taking x and y. Clear? So this is your equation 1. Equation 1 is simple. Now the second equation you will take with respect to the concentration. Okay, this is 50% concentrated. This is 80% concentrated. And you want 68% concentrated in the final, in this last beaker, you want 68% concentration. So what do you understand by 50% concentration? See, with the 50% concentration of X solution plus 80%, this is 80% concentration of the Y solution. Okay, with 80% concentration of Y solution, if I am mixing, I should get 68% concentration of the final solution. Clear? Right? So the final solution concentration is 68%. Now what do you understand by? What do you understand by 50% of X? Can you write it as 50 by 100 of X plus 80 by 100 of Y is equals to 68? Okay, clear till here? So it is 68% concentration. 50% from here you are taking, 80% from here you are taking. So the total concentration will be 68. Now let us take LCM. So you have 50x plus 80y divided by 100 is equals to 68. So 50x plus 80y transpose 100 to the other side. So you have 6800. Okay. So the same thing I can write it as from here. If I take 10 common, I have 5x plus 8y is equals to 6800. So 10 I can cancel it out. So finally I have 5x plus 8y is equals to 680. Clear till here? So this will be your equation 2. Now equation 1 was x plus y is 100 was your equation 1. Equation 2 is 5x plus 8y is equals to 680 is your equation 2. Did you all understand? How did we get this? First thing is x ml from first beaker, y ml from second beaker, total is x plus y 100 ml quantity. Second thing is 50% concentration from first beaker, 80% concentration from second beaker, total 68% concentration. Clear? Now, this is nothing but 68%. Now you might get a doubt. Yes, this is 68% of 100 ml. Okay, 68% of 100 will be how much beta? 68 of 100 divided by 100. So again, you will anyway have 68. So I have directly written here. Okay, so if you have any doubt, now this is the answer. ओके 68% ऑफ 100 ml इज नथिंग बट 68 बाय 100 इनटू 100 100 100 कैंसिल्स. नाउ नाउ इफ आई वांट टू सॉल्व दीस टू इक्वेशंस I should multiply the first equation by 5 and subtract it with the second equation. So multiply equation 1 by 5 and subtract it with equation 2. So see what will you get? 5x plus 5y is equals to 5 into 100 is 500. 5x plus 8y is equals to 680 and let's subtract it. So signs change. 5x minus 5x. 5y minus 8y is minus 3y is equals to, I'll get minus 180 here. So y is equals to minus 180 divided by minus 3. Minus minus cancel, 3 ones are 3, 6 are 0. So y value you are getting it as 60. Let us substitute this y equal to 60. Let's substitute y is equal to 60 in equation 1. So x plus y is 100. So x plus y is 60 is equals to 100. So x you will get it as 100 minus 60 is 40. Clear? So therefore the concentration, okay, how much of each? So the quantity, therefore the quantity of each solution is how much? It is 60, 40 ml is first, 40 ml and 60 ml. Clear, beta? 40 ml and 60 ml. So 40 ml from first beaker, 60 ml from second beaker. If you mix, you will get 100 ml solution and the concentration is also 68% finally. Clear with this? Last question. So you have 12,000 saved. Now this question is similar to the previous question. So you have 12,000 saved amount. So you have total of 12,000 as your savings. And want to invest it in two schemes. So you want to invest this 12,000 in two schemes. One scheme is yielding 10%. So let me take the amount invested in the scheme as X and the amount invested in this scheme as Y rupees. Okay, the total 12,000 you are investing in two schemes. In one scheme, I'm for example investing X rupees. And in the other scheme, I'm investing Y rupees. Okay, and the two schemes are yielding 10% and 15%. So this scheme is yielding 10% and this scheme is yielding 15% of income, of interest. How much amount should be invested in each scheme so that you get an overall interest of 12%? So these two interests combined, I should get 12%. So how much should I invest? That means what is X and what is Y? How much should I invest in the first scheme? How much should I invest in the second scheme? That is a question. So let us solve this. So let the amount invested in first scheme, okay, if this you are considering as first scheme and second scheme, so let the amount invested in first scheme is X rupees. Rupees X. So amount invested in second scheme, rupees Y. And total amount X plus Y gives you how much? So this total 12,000 only you are breaking and some amount in X and some amount in first scheme, some amount in second scheme you are investing. That means X plus Y is nothing but this total 12,000. This is nothing but your equation 1. Okay? And similar to the previous question, see here. Now this first scheme, okay, first scheme interest plus second scheme interest will give you the total interest 12%. Okay? Let me write it here now. First scheme interest plus second scheme interest. I want 12% of both. Okay, so which means see here, first scheme gives 10% interest of the X rupees you are investing plus second scheme gives 15% of the Y rupees you are investing. Is it similar to the previous question? That is equals to, you want 12% of whom? You want 12% of the total amount you invested. So 12% of total amount is 12,000. Okay, you invested 12,000, isn't it? 12,000. So I want 12% on the overall, okay, interest. Overall amount which I invested, which is 12,000. So let us solve this now. 10% is 10 by 100 of X plus 15 by 100 of y is equals to 12 by 100 of 12,000. That is equals to, so here I'm just writing it as 10x plus 15y. So by 100 is equals to 12 by 100 into 12,000. And here you can take 100 common. So I have 10x plus 15y, okay, divided by 100 is equals to 12 by 100 into 12,000. I have taken LCM. 100 and 100 cancel. So finally you have 10x plus 15y is equals to 12 into 12,000. Or I can write from this 5, I can take common. So 2x plus 3y is equals to 12 into 12,000. Or let us transpose 5 to the other side. So you'll have 12 into 12,000 divided by 5. So 5 1s are 5, 2s are 10, 4. You have a 2 here now. So 5 4s are 20, 0, 0. So 12 into 24. How much are you getting? So 2x plus 3y is equals to 24 into 12 we want. So it is 8, 4, 4, 8, 8, 8, 8. So 8, 8, 8, 0, 0. Okay, so this is finally what we are getting. Now x plus y is 12,000 and 2x plus 3y is 880. Let me just check one. So it is, yeah, just have a look. It is 8 and 2's are 4, 4 1's are 4, 2, this has to be 2. This has to be 2, 2 1's are 2, isn't it? So this is 2. Here also, this is 2. Right, so 28800 I got. Now this is nothing but my equation 2. Let us write both the equations here. Equation 1 is x plus y is 12,000 is equation 1. Equation 2 is 2x plus 3y is equals to 28800. This is your equation 2. Now to solve this, I have to multiply equation 1 by 2. The second equation I should multiply by 2. So equation 1 multiplied by 2 minus equation 2. So 2x plus 2y is equals to 24,000. And 2x plus 3y is equals to 28,800. So subtracting, 2x and minus 2x cancel. 2y minus 3y gives me minus y is equals to 28,000. Okay, minus 24,000. How much are you getting? 0,0,8,4. So I'm getting minus 4,800. So y will be minus and minus cancel, plus 4,800. Now substitute this y equal to 4,800. So substitute y equal to 4,800 in equation 1. So you will have x plus 4,800 is equals to 12,000. Or x is equals to 12,000 minus 4,800. So 12,000 minus 4,800. So 002511, isn't it? Yes. So you are getting it as 7,200. So how will you check this problem? How will you check this problem? Very simple. You x is to 7,200. Okay, therefore x equal to 7,200 I got, y equal to 4,800. Now if you add x plus y, you should get 12,000, isn't it? So 7,200 plus 4,800. If I'm adding these two, so yes, you will get a 12,000. So which means the amount which you got is correct. Okay, so therefore 7,200 and 4,800 are the amounts which have to be invested, okay, which has to be invested in the schemes, respectively. Okay, so in 10% scheme you will invest 7,200, in 15% scheme you will invest 4,800. Clear with this question? So with this we completed exercise 4.2, and we will be starting the next exercise in the next class. Okay, so Thank you so much for watching me. I hope you like the explanation. If yes, do like the video and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.